And the Pope did love that movie, right?
It seems like it. He said what was reported was that it is as it was, and was the kind of the final words of the Pope from what we understood through the media. And basically, I think it goes back to the fact that the Pope was a man who had courage, and he was able to say things as they were. It doesn't mean that he was saying, making any sort of political statement about it. He was just saying, the fact is, we can look at the truth. It is as it was.
Let me tell you, I was on that cross, and many people who looked up there, you know, I may be playing Christ, but a lot of times I felt like Satan, because I had obscenities wanting to come out of me, and it was so cold. It was like knives coming through you, hypothermia. I don't know if you've ever dealt with that.
No.
I wore my binoculars and I could see the towers from my windows, and this is where I'm looking, and all of a sudden down there I see this van park, and I see three guys on top of the van, and I could see that they were like happy, you know, they didn't look shocked to me, you know, they didn't look shocked.
At that point we were taken for another round of questioning, this time related to our allegedly being members of Mossad. The fact of the matter is, we are coming from a country that experiences terror daily. Our purpose was to document the event. Our purpose was to document the event.
We have all heard some absolutely incredible 9/11 conspiracy theories. The web, of course, is full of them. But tonight, we're bringing one out that feeds on racism out in the open. We were absolutely shocked by one recent poll that found out that one in every three Americans believe the terror attacks were not the work of America's enemies, but some sort of inside job. And Deborah Farrick found a smaller percentage who believe an even uglier theory.
This 9/11 attack was not by 19 Arabs. It was not by Muslims.
They talk about a Jewish plot.
Everywhere you look, you find a Zionist agent.
When you imply that somehow Israelis were involved in the attack on the World Trade Center and the Pentagon, people are going to look at you. Critics will say, you are an anti-Semite, are you?
No, I'm not an anti-Semite.
4,000 Israelis or Jews in the New York City area were warned by instant messages not to go to work on 9/11.
Let's start with the resident Jew on our panel here. I mean, you hear this stuff, and it just makes you sick to your stomach. There is absolutely no evidence that anybody other than Al-Qaeda was involved with this attack. How upsetting is this to you?
Look, we've been kicked around for 2,000 years. The face you're looking at's got a lot of anger in it because of that.
We have found the moving company where the five Israelis worked.
Was this building being used as a front for some kind of Israeli intelligence operation that possibly was doing surveillance on the Arab American community? Were there men celebrating or slapping fives or whatever?
And then, as the officer arrested him, a tirade against Jews.
Take me back to that moment as you remember it then. Officer James Mee, did you know him? Did you know he was Jewish?
I didn't know if he was or wasn't.
These are the words.
How horrible does he think they were? I read to him the officer's account of the words he used that night. Expletive Jews. And to Officer Mee, are you a Jew? And
the Jews are responsible for all the wars in the world. Mm-hmm.